Welcome back, everybody. It is time for our Monday and Friday conversation all about parenting. It can be challenging, it can be frustrating, but we've got help for you. That's why ABC4 News at 4 has teamed up with Donna Tetro for Kids Under Construction. She's joining us from LA via Zoom. And Donna, this conversation today about social media, I think, is so important for everyone who has a child in their home. Amid criticism, Facebook is delaying their Instagram Kids, which would be an app for users under the age of 13. So let's talk about what we know about this kids version of Instagram and why it's been put on a big old hold for now.
Yeah, Emily, this is really important news and something all parents should know about. You know, child advocates have been urging CEO Mark Zuckerberg and the company to stop the kids version of Instagram. And they have cited increased cyberbullying, possible vulnerability to online predators, and what they call Facebook's, quote, checkered record in protecting children on its platform. So this is an ongoing concern for child advocates and parents.
Okay, let's talk about this new report saying that Instagram is, quote, toxic for teens. It's something that a lot of parents would say, yeah, I know, I'm watching it. But now we're seeing really a report kind of backing up that idea.
Yeah, I mean, it's what parents have been feeling and noticing and seeing in their own homes. And the Wall Street Journal came out with this report. There were leak files, and it's basically saying that Instagram is toxic for teens, especially girls. And some teenage girls, leading to poor mental health issues and anxiety, and specifically citing body image issues. But you know, what about the boys? We don't know about what's in the report regarding boys. Is there anything? Did they do any research about boys? There's the comparisons, the perfect lives, the travel, et cetera. And this perpetuates that myth that external things make us happy. And so we as adults can look at Instagram and see all these great vacations and kind of it could bother us as adults. What is it doing to the teen brain? So there's so much we still don't know, but this is really important for parents to be aware that this evidence is out.
And despite all the evidence and everything that the parents know, kids are on social media. So let's just talk about the reality of it all, that it is happening.
Yeah, exactly right. This is our kids' playground, if you will, their park, their mall that they hang out. They are digital natives, so they're going to be on social media. So we have to understand that as parents and allow this process to happen. This is how they connect, right? But we have to be able to help our kids manage social media. So it's not like saying, no social media for you. It's how can I help you be safe on social media?
So let's talk about that. For a lot of parents, I think they're just at a loss of what do I do? I can't turn off the cell phone. I can't lock it away. It's going to happen no matter what. So what can parents do to help their children have a healthy relationship with this digital world?
Yeah, so definitely parents have to monitor. Full on, they have to monitor. Even if child doesn't want it, that's just part of being a parent. Just like you're not allowed to. Before the age limit, we have to monitor you on social media. But also with that, on the other side of that is trusting our teen, knowing that they just want to go there to connect and see friends, and who knows what's going to happen. It's not that we don't trust them, it's we don't trust what's going on social media. And also keeping those lines of communication open and finding out why they're on social media. Who are they following? How do they feel when they're on the app? All of these conversations, ongoing conversations, are going to help our kid be healthy and safe on social media, because this is their reality. This is their childhood.
I love that idea that this is going to be happening. But if those conversations are happening, if something bad happens, then you're more likely to hear about it from your child directly. Donna, a very important topic as always, and we appreciate you sharing some of your week with us here on Kids Under Construction. Again, we talk to Donna every Monday and Friday here on the news at 4, but you can get more from Donna at any time. Just go to our website, abc4.com, her podcast, Kids Under Construction. Several episodes waiting for you right there. You could hear as she dives deep into these topics of parenting, which for all of us is something, if you're lucky enough to be a parent, there are some trouble spots that Donna will help you work through. Also, if you've got a question for her, please send them to us, kidsunderconstruction@abc4.com. Donna, as always, thank you very much.